Good afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Friday. Fitness Friday, I guess, because we have a very special guest. We have Rainbeau Mars. We sat down and did an interview with her at Raw Spirit Fest, and I think you'll like what she has to say. She's going to tell her story, and she's going to give you a few little nuggets inside of that. So go ahead and watch. Hope you enjoy.
Point of view, and when I moved to Hollywood, of all places, is where I really got on the mat. And I'd been exposed to yoga, but that's when I really started doing it. And I was like, well, I couldn't even touch my toes.
Okay.
And I was like, what is this? Fear. And I'm going to get to the bottom of it. And that's when I moved, you know, my house, as I told you. I moved. I changed my life. I cried every day for like an hour a day. I practiced sometimes twice a day. I would write, I would journal. I gained weight. I gained pimples. I needed to know that I needed to know that no matter what I looked like, I could love myself. I was eating macrobiotics at the time. And that's how I switched into Raw eventually, which helped. It really helped. It really made me feel my body in another way. I could feel all the water, I guess, I was ingesting, and the clear energy that I was ingesting, and the tension that I had been trying to get rid of in my hips for 6 years, practicing yoga every day and like working through it and doing teacher training and figuring it out how to do the pose. It was not leaving. And when I started eating all live foods, I was like, I felt the tension in another connective way. You seem like you had this experience. Like became one with it, and then I started to let it go. That's a whole nother question, I'm sure.
So, but it took 6 years of kind of straining until you kind of moved into that new paradigm.
I don't know how. I mean, I definitely, even before that, I was flexible it took 3 years. I'm gonna say 3 years of total commitment of crying every day, doing two practices a day,
right,
and like the karma yoga and putting on weight. And although I was really self-conscious about that, and I'm much more comfortable with whatever size I am now, it was just hard because I was 20 and I was acting still, kind
right.
of. Okay, so it's 3 years of like just hell.
Yeah.
3 years of going, what in the world is inside of me and how can I get to the bottom of it? And it wasn't until I learned, kind of bringing it back to the physicalness, the materialness, because at that time I wasn't really getting real instruction. I was focused on getting to the bottom of it and maybe dramatizing it a little bit, but I became really flexible very quickly because I was like so emotional, but I was all over the place. And then I took teacher's training because I was so flexible. I had kind of risen to one of the more flexible people in the class.
Right.
So that was pretty much very quick. And then taking teacher's training gave me like all of a sudden a package. And I was the only person in the class to not raise my hand. I did not want to teach yoga. I just was like, what do I do next? Like, I want to get to the bottom of this. And then they teach you all these alignment things. And that was when it got really interesting. That's when it felt like the doors open. And I thought, oh, there's a container to this. There's a physical, material containment. You need containment to expand. If you're not contained and you want to go up, you're just going to go up, but you're not going to grow. If you're contained, my teacher said it, the Mula Bandha, which is the root lock, is the tether to the bird of prana.
Okay.
Sounds very poetic, but it's like if you have a container, and that's when, if you go down, you can go up. If you go back, you can go forward. If you go in, you can go out. But you can't go in any one of these directions by itself. And I see that in a lot of communities where the mistake is with finding yoga, with finding particular diets, that they're just trying to get, I just want to be open. I just want to love. I just want to there's always that balance. And that's where this dance is. And in the martial arts people, I experience it in Tai Chi or a lot of the martial arts masters, where there's this really intricate knowingness. They can sometimes maybe get a little more contracted, but we're just teaching each other. We're infinitely teaching, growing, learning. My teaching is really my practice. And I think ultimately what I'm learning is you just keep going for more refined balance, core strength, and enlightenment, which is knowing, self-knowing.
Did you know that you were going to be here when you were 20, doing what you're doing now? Did you have any idea? Any like hint or like...
This?
Well, not sitting here in front
of
you.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I guess it's like, I guess it's so vague. I mean, there's so many answers to that question. I mean, God, I always saw myself, for instance, in front of a lot of people, and I never knew what that meant. And I guess that's why when I was 20 was when I said, I'm to love myself so I can teach the world to love themselves. I mean, I just always, when I'd close my eyes, I'd see pictures of me being in front of a lot of people. I saw cameras shooting me. I don't know. I just had pictures of that. And pretty much, I don't think it means it's for just some people, but I do think you need to know where you're going to be where you want to be. Now, that's not for everyone. Not everyone wants to be in the public eye. No. But I had this very strong calling to know that I was supposed to be somehow of service in a way that I would be in a spotlight. And anyone, and it's just everyone that I know that's is famous knew they were going to be famous. Yeah. So I don't know if it would happen. If you don't think you're going to be famous, then you're probably not going to be. It doesn't mean...
It doesn't mean anything
except for that. Yeah, I did. I always saw myself as sort of a household name. I didn't know how that would look. I don't know if I'm a household name yet, but I do hope to bridge and be the rainbow, which I feel is my dharma, to basically connect earth to heaven. And that it's just so much, I guess, because I'm always being humbled from the experience, like really humbled, where I go back to, whoa, like deeper. What we talked about, like getting on the mat and going, okay, I've gotten a little caught up in my ego here, or I'm not really practicing my practice right now, and I need your help, like to my friend, like we're being competitive right now, or let's just be like, there's always more layers to get into. So I think on that level, I had no idea how much I would have to keep growing. You know, forever and ever and ever. And the more work that we do, it seems like the deeper the work becomes. Yeah. Because you just can't lie to yourself or anybody. And you know that it's like, you know, you just gotta keep digging.
Stop.
You just don't stop. Yeah.
Where can people find more information about you and your programs?
Oh, more information about me, rainbowmars.com. I have a website, and it's about to have an awesome makeover in about a month, so we're really excited about that.
And it's not spelled like rainbow.
No, it's Rainbeau, like the French spelling, and the Adidas website. We have Adidas TV out, as well as the clothes that my new sustainable clothing line that's eco. Sustainably harvested eucalyptus. These guys are having a lot of fun over here.
I know.
Sustainably harvested eucalyptus clothes, and they're sold on the Adidas site. And I love the idea of bridging eco-sustainability with corporate, like global moguls that can bring the information to the world. We're all one.
Yeah.
And we get to just see the person that seems the most different than you as your brother, your sister, your friend.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, thanks for watching, guys. I want you to have a great weekend. Your question of the day is, yoga, do you practice it or not? Go ahead and post that down below. We're going to be at the Harmony Festival this weekend, so please come and scope us out. We'll definitely be at Michael Beckwith's talk on Sunday, so we'll definitely be there. Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time. Yoga, yes or no?
Yes.
Yoga, yes or no?
Spontaneous yoga.
Yoga, yes or no?
Of course.
All right.